Well, ahead of the proceedings, Dan Williams spoke to Paul Evans of the University of British Columbia's School of Public Policy and Global Affairs, and he started by asking for his expectations of this next phase of Meng's hearing.
Well, the game is on. After preliminaries and discovery information that's been available to the court, now they'll be digging in directly to decisions around, in this first round, around double criminality is what Madam Meng is being accused of in the United States. Is that a criminal action here in Canada? We'll soon be then into abuse of process matters that will be in some months away, and then a sufficiency argument that comes as the third chapter.
For those that perhaps don't know, kind of what is double criminality and how much is this a crucial element of this particular hearing?
Well, it's important in the extradition treaty between the U.S. And Canada. And double criminality basically says, is the person charged, in this case in the United States, is that same action they're being charged for a criminal action in Canada? And this will become a complicated part of this proceeding because of the whether the issue is a bank fraud question or whether the issue relates to sanctions against Iran, of which the bank fraud was a part. Canada did not support those sanctions against Iran, but Canadian law, like law in every country, doesn't like fraud. Or improper information being provided. So it is it's going to be a very interesting definitional question whether this is really just about bank fraud, someone saying something that might not have been true and that they knew not to be true, or whether it's going to be about the broader political context of what that fraud was taking place inside, and that was sanctions evasions. If it's about sanctions evasions, Madam Meng's case is very powerful not to be extradited. Canada didn't support those sanctions. Most countries in the world didn't either.
Since the arrest in December 2018, what has been the impact on China-Canada relations?
Deep freeze. This is unlike any issue we've focused on since we've had diplomatic relations. It began as a difficult moment with the arrest of Madam Meng. We knew there were going to be big trouble come down the path from that one. We did some opinion polling. Most Canadians, when they were asked the question, do you feel the arrest was warranted? Most say no.